Hello, good evening everyone. Welcome to Grade Up. I'm Vikas Madhuria and I welcome you to this very important session on manometry. So as you all know that we are conducting classes in the Startup ME series, and in that series we have conducted very few important sessions on fluid mechanics subject, and in that we have conducted sessions on fluid properties, laminar flow through pipe and plate, and also we have conducted a session on hydraulic turbines, flow through jet, and now we are again going to start another topic of manometry. So I welcome you all in this very important session. I welcome to you all. Shivam Pal, very good evening to you. Hi Pawan Kumar, good evening. Good evening everyone. I welcome you to this important session. So I'll be starting this session, and right now I can see we have 11 students watching us. This is a very less number, guys. Come on. This session that we are conducting on the YouTube channel, it is especially for those who are preparing for GATE and ESC 2020. I hope you know the name of this series. The name of the series is Startup ME. Startup ME is the name of the series. Okay, in this series, we are providing these video lectures for those students who are preparing for GATE and ESC 2020. Please update the lecture in the GradeUp app. Well, Naga Vamsi, this lecture you can access from both GradeUp app and also on our YouTube channel. Okay, so automatically lecture get updated in the app. You don't have to, you just have to follow our free series in the GradeUp app. Okay? Yes? Very good evening, everyone. I'm Vikas Bhadoria and I welcome you to this very important session on fluid mechanics, that is manometry. I think there's some problem with this. Yes. So before I start the session, let's have a quick introduction of me. Those who are knowing me, those who know me, this is you all know me. But those who don't know me, those who are meeting me for the very first time, if you are having our first introduction, that is for those who are meeting me for the very first time. I'm Vikas Bhadoria, and I teach basically the subjects of thermal applied and fluid mechanics. And I have 5+ year teaching experience. I have done my M.Tech in thermal engineering from Thapar University, Patiala. It's a very good college. Those who want to pursue their M.Tech, it is a very good option for pursuing M.Tech. Okay. I have mentored more than 10,000 plus aspirants for different competitive exams like GATE, ESC, SSC, JEE. And my area of expertise include fluid mechanics, thermal applied, and heat transfer. Okay. So basically, I have done my master's in thermal engineering, and I basically teach the subjects of thermal and applied. Okay. So I'll be starting the session quickly because I don't want to waste the time in other things. Okay. Now, before I discuss about manometry, tell me what is the purpose of manometry, and we need to understand what is the purpose of using the manometers. Okay. So can you tell me what is the purpose of a manometer? Why do we need a manometer, and for what purpose? Dinesh Gangavat, the fluid kinematics lecture will be tomorrow, that is on 6th of February. So you have to wait for these 24 hours. We'll be meeting on 6th of February, that is tomorrow, for the lecture of fluid kinematics. Okay. Vivek 123, it's a very good name. Vivek 123. Okay, Vivek 123 is saying it is used to measure the pressure difference. It is used to calculate the pressure. Abhishek Kushwai is saying it is used for measuring the pressure difference. Those who are saying it is used to measure the pressure difference, it is not the actual answer. It is used to measure the pressure at a point and also the pressure difference between two points. Okay, a manometer can be used to measure the pressure at a particular point, or also it can be used to measure the pressure between two points, pressure difference between two points. That is the purpose of manometer. So the whole this whole concept of manometer is circulated along this thing which is called pressure. What is the pressure? Can you tell me what is pressure? Recently, we have conducted, you all have given the GATE exam. So you must have felt this pressure. So is this pressure related to that pressure that you guys feel while giving an exam, or giving your university exam, or giving your college exam, or giving your GATE exam, or any competitive exam? Is that pressure similar to this pressure that we are going to study in the subject of fluid mechanics? Yes. Anurag Srivastava is asking, it is saying that it is equal to normal force per unit area. So according to Anurag Srivastava, this pressure is normal force per unit area. Okay, very good. So I'm very happy to see this these positive response from you guys. His units are correct, Pawan Kumar. Well, Pawan Kumar, I will be telling you about these units. So firstly, let's focus on the definition of pressure. Pressure is basically called as normal force. The normal force which acts on a surface. Like, let's see, when I'm standing right here. So the pressure, the force which is acting normal to my surface. Okay, that force per unit cross-sectional area is called as pressure. Okay, so if I say there is a fluid element, let us say there is a fluid element, and there is a normal force which is acting on this fluid element. Let us say there is a normal force. So the normal force which is acting per unit this surface, on this surface, is called as pressure. So pressure is equal to normal force per unit area. Kiran is having a very good doubt that why we are considering only the normal force, why not any kind of force. See, first of all, you have to understand that pressure is not it is not related to the normal force. Actually, it is related to the area which is perpendicular to the force. Okay, so since this force, this pressure acts on an area which is perpendicular to the surface, the force which is acting on this area which is perpendicular to this, let us say this surface is there. Okay, so the direction of the force should be perpendicular to this surface on which the force acts. That is why it is called normal force, because the direction of this force is perpendicular to the surface on which it acts. That is why it is called as normal force, and that is why the pressure is called as normal force per unit area. Understand? So this pressure force, this pressure acts normal to the surface on which it acts. That is why it is called as normal force per unit area, and the unit is Newton per meter square or Pascal. That is called as SI unit of pressure. Okay. All right. So we have one student in the GridUp app, Arun Kumar. So very good, and it's very good, Arun Kumar, that you have purchased our Vision 2021 course. You have purchased it at the very right time, because we have started the classes from 20th of Jan in the Vision course. And so already few classes of industrial have been conducted, or we can say industrial subject is about to complete in this Vision course. So it's very good time that you have purchased this course. Okay. Kuldeep Gupta is asking about the surface tension. Kuldeep Gupta, surface tension is a topic which is not a part of this topic. Okay. And surface tension is basically defined as the tensile force which acts on the surface per unit length. Or it is equal to surface energy, the energy which acts on the surface per unit area. That is called as surface tension. But since this is not a part of this manometry, so we are not going to discuss about it. Okay? But I hope I have tried to solve your query on surface tension. Okay? Now the unit of the pressure is Pascal. The SI unit of the pressure is Pascal or Newton per meter square. And 1 Pascal is equal to... that is a mistake. This is 1 Newton per meter square. 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. That is a unit of pressure. This is a printing mistake. 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square, not mm square. While 1 megapascal is equal to 1 Newton per mm square. Why? Because 1 megapascal is equal to 10 power 6 Pascal. Right? Or it is equal to 10 power 6 Newton per meter square. Now 1 meter square is equal to 10 power minus 6 mm square. So we can say that 1 megapascal is also equivalent to 1 Newton per mm square. Okay. So these conversions are very, very important. These conversions are very, very important for converting a pressure from a unit into the standard unit of Pascal or megapascal, okay, or kilopascal. So you have to understand this conversion, you have to remember this conversion. Okay, so SI unit of this pressure is Pascal or Newton per meter square. 1 Pascal is equal to 1 Newton per meter square. 1 megapascal is equal to 1 Newton per mm square. 1 bar is equal to 10 power 5 Pascal or 0.1 Newton per mm square. Okay, and 1 atmospheric pressure. When we say atmospheric pressure, what is atmospheric pressure? The pressure that is measured with respect to the pressure of the atmosphere is called atmospheric pressure. okay, and that is measured with the help of a barometer, okay, that was invented by Torricelli. Okay, so one atmospheric pressure is equal to 101.325 kilopascal or 1.013325 bar. Okay, so one atmospheric pressure is equal to 1.01325 bar and 1 bar is equal to 10 bar 5 Pascal. So you have to remember all these conversion units. These are very, very important. I can see the number of students for this session, they are reducing. That means already they are very good in this topic of manometry. That is why they are not interested in the session, no problem. If you are very good in this topic, that is well and good, because if you see the GATE exam or ESC exam, question from manometry comes in the in these exams. So it is a very important topic. It's my request, don't leave the session. We'll be solving question also in this session and we'll understand the concept of manometry. Okay, so you have to remember this conversion unit. These are very, very important. Now this pressure, if I talk about this pressure is also of different kinds. That pressure can be atmospheric pressure, it can be gauge pressure, it can be absolute pressure, or it can be vacuum pressure. What are these different kinds of pressure? Atmospheric pressure, as you know, that the atmospheric pressure is the pressure which is exerted by the atmosphere. Okay, the pressure which is exerted by the atmosphere around us, that pressure is called as atmospheric pressure. Okay, so what is the definition which is written here? It is a pressure exerted by the environmental air. Atmospheric pressure is measured by a device known as barometer. And the device which is used to measure the atmospheric pressure is called barometer. It was invented by Torricelli. This is a brief, you can say it is a good thing for your GK. Okay, that it was invented by, this barometer is invented by Torricelli. That is why this barometer is also called as Torricelli barometer. Okay, because the barometer which measures the atmospheric pressure is invented by Torricelli. Okay, other pressure is called gauge pressure. What is called gauge pressure? Gauge pressure is that pressure which is the pressure that you get from any mechanical gauges. Okay, the pressure that is measured with the help of mechanical device, that pressure is called as gauge pressure. So what is a gauge pressure? Gauge pressure are the pressure that are measured with respect to the atmospheric pressure. Okay, that is also a kind of definition of this gauge pressure. We can understand that this gauge pressure is a pressure which is measured with the help of any by any device. Okay, if you have to measure that pressure by any device, for example, if you measure the pressure by manometer, that device is that pressure is called gauge pressure, and we have to convert this gauge pressure into absolute pressure. Okay, so this gauge pressure is also measured with respect to atmospheric pressure. And this gauge pressure can be positive gauge pressure or it can be negative gauge pressure. It can be both positive and negative. Negative gauge pressure is also called as vacuum pressure. Okay. Next is absolute pressure. What is called absolute pressure? So for solving any question of fluid mechanics or thermodynamics, we have to convert the pressure into absolute pressure. It is very, very important to convert the pressure into absolute pressure. Doubt clear, positive and negative both. Okay, Riya Sharma, this gauge pressure can be positive pressure or negative pressure. I will explain you what is this positive gauge pressure or negative gauge pressure. You have to be with me. Okay, I will be telling you this about this in the coming slides. Okay, so absolute pressure is a pressure which is measured with respect to a zero line. Okay. This absolute pressure is always a positive pressure, because if we have to do the calculation, for all calculation purpose, you have to convert the pressure into absolute pressure. Okay, if you solve any question of thermodynamics or any question of fluid mechanics, normally you have to convert the pressure into absolute pressure for numerical purpose. Okay, what is absolute pressure? Absolute pressure is always measured with respect to atmospheric and gauge pressure. Okay. Either it is a sum of atmospheric and gauge pressure, or it is a difference of atmospheric and gauge pressure. Okay, but absolute pressure is always a positive quantity. It is always positive. Okay. Now, what is a vacuum pressure? What is vacuum pressure? Vacuum pressure is that pressure which is less than the atmospheric pressure. If the pressure is less than the atmospheric pressure, then that is called as vacuum pressure. And vacuum pressure is also called as negative gauge pressure. It is also called negative gauge pressure. Now, to understand all these kind of pressure, let us say that there is a line. Let us say there is a this line, and let us say this is a zero line. Let us say this is a zero line. What is zero line? The zero line is a line with respect to which is having zero pressure. It is having zero Pascal pressure. Let us say it is having zero Pascal pressure. It is having zero pressure. That is called a zero line. Okay. So it is a reference line. Let us say it is a reference line with respect to all the pressure will be measured. Okay. Now from this zero line, let us say there is this line which is called as atmospheric pressure line. Let us say it is atmospheric pressure which is equal to 1.01325 bar or 101.325 kilopascal. Okay. So one line is called zero line, other is called atmospheric pressure line. Okay. Now I will be drawing two more lines. Now let us say these are the two lines. This is H, and this is also, let us say it is also equal to H. The pressure that you will be getting at this point will be called as gauge pressure. This is also a gauge pressure. This gauge pressure depends on this height. Okay. This gauge pressure depends on this height. If you measure the pressure from the zero line, this complete pressure is called as absolute pressure. This complete pressure is called as absolute pressure, and this absolute pressure is the sum of gauge pressure, the total sum of gauge pressure, because this is a gauge pressure, this complete thing is gauge pressure, okay, above atmospheric pressure, and this is the atmospheric pressure. The sum of gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure is called as absolute pressure. This is called as positive gauge pressure. This gauge pressure is positive, and this gauge pressure is negative gauge pressure. Okay, and this negative gauge pressure is also called as vacuum pressure. It is also called as vacuum pressure. Okay. Now, if we have to find the absolute pressure, like I have told you, this absolute pressure is the sum of the total pressure from this zero line to this line. Okay, so the total pressure will be equal to gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure, that is called as absolute pressure. Okay. If we have to find absolute pressure with respect to this line, then this we can also write as absolute pressure is also equal to, let us say that we have to find the pressure at any point here below this line. If we have to find the pressure at any point below this line, then absolute pressure will be equal to atmospheric pressure minus gauge pressure. So you have to understand that if you have to find the pressure, absolute pressure below this atmospheric pressure line, then the total absolute pressure will be equal to atmospheric pressure minus gauge pressure, because below the atmospheric pressure line, the pressure is, gauge pressure is negative. Okay, that is why the total absolute pressure below the atmospheric pressure line will be equal to atmospheric pressure minus gauge pressure. But if we have to measure the pressure above the atmospheric pressure line, then this absolute pressure will be the sum of the gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure, because the gauge pressure above this atmospheric pressure line will be positive pressure, but the gauge pressure below this atmospheric pressure line will be negative pressure. Okay, so always remember this fact, that total absolute pressure depends on both gauge pressure and atmospheric pressure. It is basically the sum of gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure. If we have to measure the pressure at this point 1, then this gauge absolute pressure will be gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure. And if we have to measure the pressure at, let us say, this point 2, then that the absolute pressure will be equal to atmospheric pressure minus gauge pressure, because this point 2 is lying below the atmospheric pressure. And below the atmospheric pressure, gauge pressure is negative. It is also called as vacuum pressure. Okay. Now, if we have to study manometer, Yes, yes, very good, Riya Sharma. Riya Sharma is very, very intelligent. The reason why if we have to measure the pressure below the atmospheric pressure, the reason why it is equal to atmospheric pressure minus gauge pressure, because absolute pressure has always, it has to be always positive. It is always positive quantity. So if absolute pressure is always a positive quantity and we have to make it a positive quantity, then if we have to measure the pressure above the atmospheric pressure, because this pressure at above atmospheric pressure, the total absolute pressure will be gauge pressure, it is positive, and plus atmospheric pressure, it is also positive. So that will be the total absolute pressure at this point. But if you are going down, in that case, the pressure will be, this gauge pressure is negative. So absolute pressure is always the sum of, absolute pressure will always be the sum of gauge pressure plus atmospheric pressure. It is not going to change. This definition will remain same. Only difference is that if you go downward, then a gauge pressure becomes negative. In that case, absolute pressure becomes atmospheric pressure minus gauge pressure. Okay? Now we have to also understand this law, which is called as hydrostatic law. What is called hydrostatic law? Hydrostatic law basically tells you about the variation of the pressure with respect to the height. How does the pressure will vary with respect to the height, or how the pressure will vary in the vertical direction? If you go in the downward direction or in the upward direction, how the pressure is going to vary? So this law is called as hydrostatic law. Why it is called hydrostatic law? Because this is a subject of fluid mechanics, and we are studying about the effect of the fluid, and or basically the fluid can be either water or it can be some other kind of fluid. So that is why it is called hydrostatic law. Hydrostatic law basically tells you about the variation of the pressure in a fluid in the vertical direction, and it tells you that the variation of the pressure of the fluid in the vertical direction with respect to height is proportional to, it is equal to rho into g. This is called as hydrostatic law. The variation of the pressure with respect to height or in the vertical direction is directly proportional to the specific weight. What is specific weight? First lecture of fluid properties in the startup series, I have told you specific weight is equal to weight per unit volume. So specific weight is equal to weight per unit volume. Weight is equal to mg, volume is equal to v. So this is equal to rho into g. So specific weight is equal to rho into g. So according to hydrostatic law, the total force, the total pressure with respect to vertical direction is directly proportional to the specific weight. Okay, and specific weight is equal to weight per unit volume. So we can say this is the hydrostatic law. If we have to derive this hydrostatic law, let us say there is a fluid element. Let us say this is a fluid element. Okay. And we have a fluid around this fluid element. Let us say we have air around this fluid element. So this air will be exerting some atmospheric pressure on the fluid element. Okay. Now due to this atmospheric pressure will be exerting a pressure force. This pressure force, pressure is equal to force per unit area. So force will be equal to pressure into area. So let us say on this fluid element, the force will be equal to P into dA, right? So, and also let us say the weight of the fluid element is equal to M into G. Let us say the weight is equal to M into G. We know that mass is equal to, it is equal to density into volume. It is equal to density into volume. Okay. What is volume? Volume is equal to area into, it is equal to area into the height. Let us say the height of this fluid element is equal to dH. Okay. And area is equal to dA. Area is equal to dA. And height is equal to dH. Okay. So we can say the weight will be equal to, which is equal to M into G, that will be equal to rho into G, okay, into what is volume, dA into dH, that will be the total volume, okay, so that will be the total weight, okay. Now opposite to this pressure force, due to Newton's third law of motion, Sir, I am joined the year class. How to join? I have no idea. Rohit Raj, if you want to join our Vision 2021 course, the links for the Vision 2021 course are given in the description of this video lecture. Okay, so if you see the description of this video, in that description you can find the link for the Vision 2021 course. Okay. Now, opposite to this pressure force, there will be a pressure force which will be opposite, equal and opposite to this pressure which is acting in this direction. Okay. And that will be equal to P plus dP into dA. Okay. Now, if you equalize the forces according to, if you apply the equilibrium of forces, the net force in this direction will be equal to M into A. Okay. And that will be equal to, we have no acceleration because it is a, since we are studying the hydrostatic law and we are studying fluid, it comes under fluid statics. That means fluid is at rest. Okay, so if the fluid is at rest, then in that case, acceleration will be equal to zero because there will be no change in velocity. So we can say net force will be equal to zero, right? So with respect to that diagram, the net force will be equal to what? P plus dA plus rho g into dA into dH. And that will be equal to PdA plus dP into dA. This will get cancelled out. So we can say that from here, you will get dP by dH is equal to rho into g. Okay? So the total pressure per unit in the total variation of the pressure in the vertical direction with respect to height is equal to rho into g. This is called as hydrostatic law. This is called as hydrostatic law. And why we are calling it hydrostatic? Because you have to understand, this law is only applicable for a static fluid. It is only applicable for a static fluid. That means a fluid which is at rest. A fluid which is at rest. That is called as a static fluid. And that is the reason why we are saying that the acceleration will be equal to zero, because the fluid is at rest, there will be no change in velocity, there will be no acceleration. So the total sum of forces will be equal to zero. Now, Rishabh Das is asking about how came rho g into dA into dH. Very good question. Very good question. So I have to tell you this thing. Weight is equal to m into g. Right? What is mass? Mass is equal to density into volume. Now, what is volume? Volume is equal to area into the height. That is the volume, total volume of the body is equal to area into the height. Now, what is area? Area will be equal to, let us say it is equal to small fluid element, that will be dA. Height will be dH. Okay? So if you substitute this value here, that will be rho into, m into g, that is also multiplied by g, that will be rho into g into dA into dH. That is how we are getting the value of weight is equal to rho into g into dA into dH. Okay? Arun Kumar, dP by dH is equal to a constant, yes. dP by dH is equal to constant. So what we get next? What is the relation that we get next? That this is hydrostatic law. The variation of the pressure in the vertical direction is proportional to the specific weight. This is a constant quantity. This is constant. Okay. So what is the meaning of this thing? That means the pressure, if you integrate this pressure with respect to height, you will get that this pressure is equal to rho into g into h. The pressure varies with the height. So total pressure varies with the height, and this pressure is called as the gauge pressure, which is equal to rho into g into h. Gauge pressure varies with the height. So the gauge pressure only varies with the height of the fluid. The height by which the fluid rises in the tube, that is the pressure only varies with the height, because rho and g are constant. So pressure will only vary with the height. Okay. Now, one thing that you have to make sure is, as we move vertically down in a fluid, the pressure increases by rho gh value. As we move vertically up in a fluid, the pressure will decrease by minus rho gh value. So, if you go downward, If you go downward, the pressure will increase. If you go upward, the pressure will decrease. And this concept is very, very important. This concept is very, very important. If you go downward in the downward direction, the pressure will increase. If you go in the upward direction, pressure will decrease. And this is the reason if you have gone in some very important point up, minus and down, positive. Very good. Very good, Riya Sharma. I don't know whether you have done any trekking or if you have climbed a hill. If you have boarded any plane so far, if you go to some height, you will feel that you find some difficulty in breathing. Okay, you find some difficulty in breathing, or you find that there is some uneasiness. You feel some uneasiness. If you climb to a height, you will feel some uneasiness. This uneasiness is basically because of this low pressure that take place if you go to some height. Okay, so if you go to some height, if you go climb a height, you will feel low pressure. Due to this low pressure, you feel the pain in the ears and some breathing problems. This is basically due to low pressure. And this low pressure is basically, you must have experienced if you have boarded any plane, if you have gone to some place with the help of, if you have boarded a flight, you or if you have sit on a plane, you must have felt this air pressure. This air pressure is due to low pressure. If you go away from the height, if you go away from the sea surface, you will find that the pressure is very low and you will find difficulty in breathing and difficulty in, you will feel very high pain in the ears. This pain in the ears or this pain in difficulty in breathing is basically due to low pressure. Okay? So you have to understand this fact. This pressure varies only with the height. This is equal to rho into g into h. And if you go in the upward direction, pressure will decrease. If you go in the downward direction, pressure will increase. This concept is important for solving the question of manometry. If you have to solve a question of manometry, you have to solve these. You have to remember this concept. Okay? Saurabh Singh is having this question. Sir, area is directly proportional to pressure. Please explain. Sir, be honest with you. I know something, but with your lecture, doing revision. Okay, Riya Sharma, very good. If you know about this thing, if you know anything about manometry, that is very good if you know about it. And it's good that you are revising the concepts. Very good. Saurav Singh is having this question that pressure is directly proportional to the area. Well, I hope you know, Saurav Singh, pressure is equal to force per unit area. So pressure is inversely proportional to area, not directly proportional to area. Pressure and area relation is this, and pressure and height are having this relation. Pressure is equal to rho gh. If you go in the upward direction, pressure will decrease. If you go in the downward direction, pressure will increase, because we measure the pressure with respect to sea level. Pressure is measured with respect to sea level. So if you are, suppose you are on the top of the earth, this is your earth, and let us say we have sea here. So from the sea level, if you go in the upward direction, the pressure will be minus rho gh. But if you go in the downward direction, the pressure will be plus rho gh. You have to understand this concept. It is very, very important. Okay, if you go away from the sea level, the pressure will decrease. It will be minus rho gh. If you go downward in the downward direction close to sea level, the pressure will increase. And below the sea level, pressure is very, very high, because below the sea level, the pressure will depend on density of water. And density of the water is greater than density of the air. So below the sea level, the pressure will be very, very high as compared to above the sea level. Okay? So these are some basic concepts that you guys must know about it. Okay? Now, this topic is all about manometry. We have understood the concept of manometer. We have understood the concept of pressure and what is pressure, how do we measure the pressure? It is equal to rho gh. If you go upward, pressure is negative. If you go downward, pressure is positive. Okay. Now, how do we measure the pressure? If you have visited any industry or if you have visited any fluid mechanics lab, in the fluid mechanics lab, you must have seen this manometer. What is a manometer? Yes, can you tell me what is a manometer? Raj Singh is having a very general doubt. He is asking about, sir, how to convert the pressure into height, in terms of height of the water column. So we know that Raj Singh, we know that pressure is equal to rho gh, right? So if you know this pressure and if you have to find the pressure in terms of height of the pressure, then h will be equal to p by rho g. So if you have to find the pressure in terms of height of the pressure column, you just have to divide the pressure by density and the acceleration due to gravity, and you will get the pressure in terms of height of the water column or mercury column. Okay, so that is only a basic concept. You can convert this pressure in terms of height of the pressure or in terms of pressure. Okay. Now the manometers are devices which are used to measure this pressure. Manometer is a device which is used for measuring the pressure. Okay. For measuring the pressure, we have different kinds of devices. We can have manometer, we can have mechanical gauges. Okay. So mechanical gauges are the devices which basically we use for measuring the pressure, which depends on some mechanical instrument. There is no as such application of the fluid in that. But in the manometer, we have application of fluid mechanics for measuring the pressure, or we have application of fluid pressure for measuring the pressure. That means in the manometer, we have two kinds of manometer, simple manometer and differential manometer. Another is mechanical gauges. In your syllabus, you don't have to study the mechanical gauges. Mechanical gauges is not a part of, it is not a part of fluid mechanics. It is a part of mechanical manometry. Fluid mechanics. Okay, so you have to only study this manometer, simple manometer and differential manometer for the subject of fluid mechanics. Okay. In simple manometer, it's basically used to measure the pressure at a point. If you have to measure pressure at a point, at a particular point, if we have to measure at a very particular point, then we use a simple manometer. But if we have to find the difference in the pressure between two points, if we have to find difference in pressure between two points, then we use a differential manometer. Differential manometer is used for finding the difference in pressure between two points, and simple manometer is used to find the pressure at a particular point. Okay. Very good. Those who have replied to this query, that what is the manometer? So you have to study about this manometer. This can be piezometer. Piezometer is also called a simple manometer. It can be a simple U-tube manometer, or it can be inclined manometer. In differential manometer, we have U-tube differential manometer, we have inverted U-tube manometer. Okay. So this is a simple manometer which is called piezometer. What is a piezometer? See, manometer is a device. It is a kind of a glass tube which is connected to that part in which we have to measure the pressure. Let us say this is a manometer. It is a kind of a glass tube. One part is open to the atmospheric pressure, and other part, this part is connected to this device, this reservoir, for which we have to measure. Let us say it is a point A, okay, and you have to find the pressure at this point A, okay, and this is your manometer. So this manometer, which is called piezometer, Rohit Kumar is having again a very general doubt. Rohit Kumar, I will definitely reply to your question after some time. Okay, so don't think that I'm ignoring your question. I will reply to your query after a very short time. Okay, so please wait for some time. So piezometer is a device which is also used for measuring the pressure, and it is basically a glass tube. This glass tube is connected to one part is connected to the reservoir for which you have to measure the pressure. Let us say this is a reservoir for of which we have to measure the pressure at a point A, okay? And this is a glass tube. One part is open to the atmosphere, other part is connected to this reservoir. Due to the difference of the pressure, let us say the pressure at this point, PA, it is greater than the atmospheric pressure. Due to this reason, if the pressure at this point is greater than the atmospheric pressure, let us say this is the initial level. Let us say this is the final level. So as soon as some liquid is filled into this tube, this is going to rise into this liquid is going to rise in this tube. Okay, from this initial level to a final level, the total height for which the liquid rises in this tube is used to measure the pressure at this point. The pressure at the point A will be equal to rho into g into h. So that is a function of manometer. It is used to find the pressure only at a particular point. If you have to find the pressure at a particular point, for that purpose we use a piezometer. Okay, Kuldeep Datta, why you are leaving the session? Still we are going to the session is still going on, and we have to solve few question also. I have taken 6 question for this session, so please, it's my request, don't leave the session. So for piezometer, only thing different is that piezometer are not used for measuring high pressure and gas pressure. Piezometer are only used only for very low pressure. Piezometer are used for measuring very low pressure. They are not used for measuring high pressure and the pressure of the gas. That is the disadvantage of the piezometer. Okay. Next is a simple U-tube manometer. What is a simple U-tube manometer? A simple U-tube manometer is a manometer which is in the form of a U-tube. It is a form of a U. The tube is bent in the form of a U shape. That is called a simple U-tube manometer. This U-shaped tube is connected to the reservoir of which you have to measure the pressure. Let us say this is point O. Okay, you have to measure the pressure at this point O. This is a simple U-tube manometer. Okay, and let us say this is the initial level. The initial level of the water was that, but as soon as this U-tube manometer is connected to this point, the pressure is going to rise up to this height. Okay. So if we have to find the pressure with the help of this simple U-tube manometer, okay, let us say this is a level which is given here. This is a reference line, and you have to find the pressure. How to find this pressure with the help of a simple U-tube manometer? How to apply the equation? So if we have to find the pressure at this point O, I'm going to write the question here. Sir, why can't we measure the gas pressure through piezometer? Monu Kumar. This is a very good question. I totally understand that. Very good question. So, Monu Kumar, you know that gases are usually compressible. Gases are called as compressible, right? So, something which is compressible will be having very high pressure, because pressure is equal to rho into RT. For a gas, pressure will be equal to rho into RT. So, gases are usually compressible. So gases are basically having more pressure. They are having very high pressure as compared to liquid. Okay. So since piezometer is not used for measuring very high pressure, that is the reason why a piezometer is not used for measuring high pressure and gas pressure, because gas pressure is automatically very, very high. That is the reason why the piezometer is not used for measuring high pressure or gas pressure. Okay. So I hope I have solved your queries, Monu Kumar and Riya Sharma. That was a good question. Okay. So if with respect to this diagram of simple U-tube manometer, let us say this question comes in the exam, that you have to measure the pressure at this point. Okay. This is a reservoir. You have to find the pressure at this point. You have to apply the equation to find the pressure. Okay, let us say this part of the liquid is having density of rho into m. We have mercury in this part, okay? And this part is containing a liquid which is having density of rho naught, okay? So if you have to find the pressure up to this point, that pressure will be equal to P naught, which is the pressure at this point, plus because we are going downward. If we go in the downward direction, pressure will be added, right? If you go in the downward direction, the pressure will get added up, right? You have to understand this concept. Okay, so that will be rho naught. What is pressure with respect to height? Pressure is equal to rho into g into h. So since we are going in the downward direction, the pressure will be P naught plus rho naught into g. Now up to this point, the liquid is, let us say up to this point, the liquid is having density of rho naught. After this level, the liquid is having this density of rho m, which is having mercury as a liquid. Okay, so that up to this height, the pressure, this pressure will be rho naught into g h plus x. Okay, that will be the total pressure up to this height. That will be h plus x into rho naught into g, right? If we go in the downward direction further, this height is equal to y, and the liquid now is equal to, liquid is having density of rho m, which is having mercury as a liquid. Okay, so that means you have to add the value of rho m into g into y. Okay, now further if we go in the upward direction, what you will be now from this point, this level, you have to again come to this level. So that means you have to subtract this density of minus rho m into gy, right? Now this, from this point, you have to again come to this point, because at this point is having atmospheric pressure which is equal to zero. Okay, so that means after this point, you have to go up to this point, that will be minus rho m into g into x equal to zero. So that is a complete equation for finding the pressure. If you have to find the pressure P naught, this equation will be used for finding the pressure P naught. Okay, so remember this concept. If you go downward direction, pressure will get added up. If you go in the upward direction, pressure will get subtracted. Okay, now next is differential U2 manometer. Let us say this is a differential U2 manometer. Only difference is that differential U2 manometer is used to find the difference in pressure between two points. Let us say these are two reservoirs. This is reservoir number one, and this is reservoir number two. Okay, let us say this is denoted by x and y. Okay, let us say this is reservoir x and this is reservoir y. Okay, these two reservoirs are connected with a U2 manometer. It is a differential U2 manometer, and you have to find the difference in the pressure Px minus Py. You have to find this value, difference in the pressure between two reservoir. Okay, how you are going to find the difference in the pressure? So if you have to find the difference in the pressure between these two points, how you are using this concept of manometry? So again, you have to apply the concept of hydrostatic law. From this point, it will be Px, okay? So that will be Px, which is the pressure at this point, right? At this point, plus if you go in the downward direction, density at this point is equal to rho into x. So density up to this point, density is equal to rho x. So up to this point, density is same. It is equal to rho base x. Okay. So that will be rho x into g. Now the total height up to this point is equal to y plus h plus x. So that will be y plus h plus x. Okay. That is the total height. The total height is equal to rho g x. Okay. Sorry, that will be y plus h plus x. Now after this level, the liquid is mercury. Here it contains mercury as a liquid, which is having density of rho m. Okay. So we have reached up to this height. Now from this height, we have to go up to this point. This is a final point. This is a final point which is having the pressure of Py. Okay. So from this point, we have to go upward. right? If we go in the upward direction, pressure will get subtracted. Because if we go in the upward direction, pressure will be negative. If we go in the downward direction, pressure will be positive. So we are going in the upward direction, that will be minus into rho m into gx, because the height is equal to x. Then we will be using minus rho y. The density of this liquid is rho y. So that will be minus rho y into g into the height is h, and that will be rho is that will be equal to minus g y, rho p y equal to 0. So from here you can find the value of px minus py, that will be equal to, you can solve it from here, okay? Similarly, what is the U2 manometer? Our differential inverted U2 manometer. What is the inverted U2 manometer? If you invert the U2 manometer, okay, if the U2 manometer becomes inverted type, it is called differential U2 manometer. Okay, so what is the principle of differential U2 manometer? Inverted U2 manometer or inverted differential U2 manometer. Inverted differential U2 manometer are used when the pipelines are underground. In those cases, manometer density of the manometric fluid is less than the density of the flowing fluid. So a differential U2 manometer is a differential inverted U2 manometer is basically used for underground pipelines. For underground pipelines, if you have to measure the pressure of underground pipelines, for that purpose we use a differential inverted U2 manometer. Okay, like Ronald Joshi, it is a very good name. Ronald Joshi has given this. He is saying that manometer can be used to measure the flow of underground water. Yes, if you have to measure the flow or pressure of underground water, we use a differential inverted U2 manometer. Okay, why? Because differential U2 manometer, the density of the manometric fluid is less than the density of the fluid which is flowing in the pipe. Okay, let us say it is an inverted time manometer. How you are going to find the pressure for this inverted time manometer? Let us say we have to find the px minus py. Okay, so for up to this height, the density of the liquid is rho x, and up to this height, the density of the liquid is rho y. Okay, and this is having density of rho m. Okay, so you can say that px, if you start from here, this point, px minus rho x into g into y plus x. The total height is equal to y plus x. This total height is equal to y plus x. And up to this height, the density is same, right? Density is equal to rho x. Okay, that will be minus, because we are moving in the upward direction now. That will be minus rho x into g into y plus x. Now from this height, we have to go in the downward direction, right? We have to go in the downward direction, but this liquid is having density of rho m. So that will be plus rho m into g into x, okay? Now further you have to go in the downward direction, that will be plus rho y into g into h plus y. That will be equal to py. So from here you can find the px minus py. So that is a differential U2 manometer. Now you won't understand this concept of manometer unless you don't solve any question. Okay. So if we have to solve the question of a manometer, I'm having few questions. Let us solve them and we can understand the concept. So this is the first question. You can solve this question and you can tell me the answer for this question. I'm waiting for your answer. You please solve the question in 2 minutes. Kuldeep Singh, yes, a differential U2 meter can be made as an inverted U2 manometer. Only difference is that the liquid in the manometer, in the case of an inverted manometer, the liquid in the manometer has got less density as compared to density of the liquid in the reservoir or in the pipe. Okay, so that is the concept of the inverted U2 manometer, that the liquid in the manometer becomes, it is having less density as compared to the density of the liquid in the pipe. Okay, solve this question, tell me the answer quickly. Come on guys. Yes, come on guys, quickly, come on. We understood the concept. Now we just have to apply that concept and solve the question. See, the question from manometers are very, very simple. You just have to stick to one basic rule, that go upward, pressure will be subtracted, go downwards, pressure will be added. Simple. Use that concept, solve the question and tell me the answer quickly. Come on guys, I know it's 10 p.m. You guys either are waiting for your dinner or you have done your dinner. See, I'm still not having my dinner. I still did not have my dinner. So guys, let's show some energy to me. Please guys, show some energy and solve this question. Come on guys. Saurabh Singh is giving the answer as 1200, okay? Yes, Mohammad Tawsif is saying 2.35. Well, Mohammad Tawsif, it is not in the options. This is not given the option even. Kranti Gupta, we can use any liquid. Basically, in the manometer, if you are having this question, I should tell you that in the manometer, normally we use mercury as the manometric fluid. Why? Because mercury is having good quality of pressure, vapor pressure. It is having high vapor pressure. It is having high thermal conductivity and thermal expansion. So these are some qualities for which mercury is generally preferred as a manometric fluid. But we can use any liquid for the manometer, okay? So next question is, yes, come on guys. The right answer for this question is option C, that is 900. Those who have given option C as the answer, I think nobody has given option C. Except Krishna Ram. Krishna Ram in the app has given option C as the answer. Very good, Krishna Ram. In the YouTube, no one has given the right answer as option C. Let us see how to solve this question. See, it is an inverted type manometer, and you have to find the difference in the pressure between point A and B. Okay? So just see the solution here, okay? This is a point A. I'll be starting from this point, okay? Up to this point, up to this height, the height is 0.5 and the density is, specific gravity is 0.9. You have to find the pressure in Newton per meter square. Okay, that is in Pascal. So that will be PA, okay? Now if we are going upward, the pressure will be subtracted minus, the specific gravity is given to you, 0.9. Specific gravity is 0.9. The density will be 0.9 into 1000, right? That will be minus 900. You have to take acceleration due to gravity as 10. That will be into 10 into, this height is 0.5. That is 0.5. Okay? Further, you have to go up to this height, that is 0.3 meter. For this height, the density, specific gravity is 1. That is, it is liquid. Only for water, specific gravity is equal to 1. So density will be 1000, right? So that will be minus of, because we are going upward, that will be minus of 1000. Minus of 1000 into 10. Into 10 is the acceleration due to gravity into h. What is the height here? 0.3. Right? But one thing you have to understand, guys, one thing you have to understand is this level is given here, and one level which is given here is this. I know this total height is given to you 0.3, but they have given these two levels. One level is this, that is, that, let us say this is 1, and another level is this 2. So you have to find, let us say, we have to find the pressure difference between these two points. So these are the two reference level that you have to take, okay? So we'll not take 0.3 as the height. What will this height? What will be this height? What will be this height? Yes, what will be this height? This height, which is the difference between these two heights, two reference lines, 1 and 2, this height will be equal to, this is total 0.7, 1.17, and this is 0.5, this will be 0.2. Okay. So what is the need of going up to this height when we can go up to this height and we can return from here? There's no need to go up to this height and return from there. Okay. So we can subtract into 0.2, and from this height we just have to go downward direction. That will be equal to plus, this is having the specific gravity of 800, that is plus 800 into 10 into 0.7 is equal to P into P. Okay, if you take this aside, this will be PA minus PB will be equal to, PA minus PB will be equal to, you can solve it from here and you will get 900 Newton per meter square. Okay, so the answer for this question will be option C, that is 900 Newton per meter square. That will be the answer. Next question. The standard atmospheric pressure is 101.325 kilopascal. The local atmospheric pressure is 96.13 kilopascal. If the pressure of the flow is pressure of the fluid is recorded as 13.8 kilopascal, which is the gauge pressure, you have to find that what is the absolute pressure. You have to find the absolute pressure. It is a very easy question. Yes, a very simple and easy question. They have given the standard atmospheric pressure, the local atmospheric pressure, and the value of gauge pressure. You have to find the absolute pressure. It is a very simple and easy question. Just use the concept that I have taught you in this lecture and solve the question. Yes, the answer for this question will be Ajay. Ronald is saying option B, Kuldeep is saying option B. In the app, if I see in the app, Arun Kumar is saying option A, Avinash Ranjan saying 88.145, Anurag is saying 114. The right answer for this question will be option B, that is 109.31. Those who have given the right answer as option B, that is the correct answer, very good. Those who have marked option B as the answer, that is a very good response. Now, how to solve this question? The standard atmospheric pressure is 101.325 kilopascal. Okay. So absolute pressure is equal to what? It is equal to the local atmospheric pressure. Always remember, it is equal to local atmospheric pressure plus gauge pressure. Okay, it is equal to local atmospheric pressure plus gauge, not a standard atmospheric pressure. We should not take a standard atmospheric pressure, because standard atmospheric pressure is a fixed quantity. It does not change. Okay, if we have to solve the question, if we have to find absolute pressure, we have to take the local atmospheric pressure, which is given here, 96.3. It is varying with respect to the given condition. That is why it is called local atmospheric pressure. The local atmospheric pressure is 96.13. The standard atmospheric pressure is a fixed quantity, it does not change. Only thing which changes is the local atmospheric pressure. So we have to take the local atmospheric pressure, that will be 96.13 plus 13.18 kilopascal, and the answer will be 109.31 kilopascal. Okay, so that was a very easy question. Those who have marked the right answer, kudos to you guys, very good. Next question. It is again a very good question. Consider the U-tube differential manometer as shown in the figure. The magnitude of the pressure difference between the point A and B, you have to find in kilopascal. You have to find the pressure in kilopascal. Don't forget these readings. The unit, you have to take care of the units, guys. You have to find the pressure in kilopascal, not in pascal, okay? So please find the pressure in kilopascal. I hope the diagram is visible to you. Yes, please confirm me whether the diagram is visible to you, the values given in the diagrams are visible to you or not. Okay, so this is A, this is specific gravity 1.6. This height is 2.5. This height is 1.2. This is a specific gravity of 0.8. Okay, and here it is mercury. So this is liquid is having the density of 13,136,000 kg per meter cube because it is mercury. Okay. So diagram is visible to you or not? So I have told you about all the values which is given in this diagram. These are the two reservoirs A and B. Specific gravity up to this point is 1.6. This height is 2.5. Okay. This height is 1.2. This is mercury. This is specific gravity 0.8. Okay. Raj Singh, I feel so happy to see that you have joined this paid course because of me. If you have joined that because of me, because I'll be taking these two subjects, fluid mechanics and machinery and thermal and applied. Okay. So my classes of fluid mechanics will be started from 3rd of March. Okay. So fluid mechanics will start from 3rd of March. But just studying the fluid mechanics and thermal applied is not going to help you at all. You have to study all the subjects. Okay, so I request you to pay attention to all the subjects. All the faculties that are teaching in this course are very good faculties. And you have to study all the subjects to get the marks in the GATE and ESC exams. Okay, I'll be taking my lecture on fluid mechanics from 3rd of March. Okay, in the paid course. So I'm very happy to hear from you that you have joined the paid course because of me. So that is a very good and honest feedback. Thank you so much. But I will not be the only one to take all the classes of all the subjects. Other faculties are also there. Okay, so I will be only covering my subjects, that is thermal and applied thermodynamics, that is IC engine, refrigeration, air conditioning, power plant and thermodynamics, along with fluid mechanics and machinery. Okay, rest subject will be taken by other faculties. Yes, have you solved the question? Naveen is getting 211.11 kilopascal. Donald is getting 245.2. It is an NAT type question. This type of question that are asked in the exam are called NAT type question. That is numerical answer type question, where you don't get any option. You just have to solve the question and fill in the blank. These are also called fill in the blanks or NAT type question, numerical answer type question. Okay. Now how to solve this question? Those who have not got the answer, the right answer for this question is 201.69 kilopascal. That is the right answer for this question. Okay. So those who have got this value, that is the right answer for this question. Riya Sharma, Monu Kumar, they are absolutely correct for this question. The right answer is 201.69. If I see in the app, I can see Arun Kumar is getting 126, Ajay Raj is getting 237, Mohammad Tawsif is getting 205.6. Okay. So how to solve this question? Even if you are getting 202 approximately, that is also correct. Okay. Now how to solve this question? If you have to find the difference in the pressure PA minus PB. So you have to find difference in the pressure PA minus PB in this question. Whenever you have to solve the question of manometry, start from any point. If you are starting from this point, let us say this is a point A. So it will be P into A, PA minus. Specific gravity here is 1.6. Specific gravity is 1.6. What will be the density? Density will be 1600. Okay, so that will be minus. Now that will be minus or plus. We are going downwards. The height up to here is 4 meter. And up to this point, the liquid is having same gravity, 1.6. It is having same gravity, 1.6. Okay. So it will be plus 1600 into 9.81 into 4, right? Because up to this, from this point up to this point, specific gravity is same, right? It is specific gravity is 1.6, right? So we will be, that will be 1600, density will be 1600 into 9.81 into 4. Now from this height, after this point, the liquid is having mercury as a liquid. It is having mercury as the manometric liquid. So mercury is having density of 13,136,00. So we have to go downward. So that will be plus 13,600 into 9.81 into, this height is 1.2 into 1.2. Now if you, from this height we have to reach up to this point. Now this, do you know the value of this height? We have to find this height, right? We have to find the value of this height, okay? So what will be this height, this complete height? Because we have to find the difference in the pressure between these two points. This point and this point, right? So we have to find this height. Okay, how to find this height? This height is given to you 4. This is 2.5. So if this is 4, this is 2.5. We can say that this height will be equal to what? 1.5, right? This will be 1.5 and this is 1.2. So total height will be 2.7. This complete height is 2.7. Okay. Now we have to go up in the upward direction. So that will be minus. We have to subtract it. So that will be minus. Specific gravity is 0.8. So that will be 800 into 9.81 into, this height is 2.7 into 2.7, okay, and that will be minus PB equal to 0. Now we have to find the PA minus PB, okay. So now you can solve it very easily. You just have to solve it. Just solve all this value, 1600 into this, 9.81 into 4 plus this minus this, and you will get the answer. And that answer will be coming out to be 201.69 kilopascal. That will be the answer for this question. Okay. Pavan Kumar is having this question that in the startup course, is other subjects, are we going to conduct other subjects? Yes. In the startup free classes, other subject will also be conducted. Okay. So you just have to wait for it. After the subject of fluid mechanics, that is from tomorrow onwards, after tomorrow class of fluid mechanics, we'll be starting other classes of other subjects, okay, in the startup classes. Austin, the Vision 2021 classes are free up to this week only. So if you want to purchase the class, if you want to study from Vision 2021 course, please join the course. It's my request, because we are going to do partial locking after, I think, this week. At the end of this week, we are going to do the partial locking. Well, I'm not sure about it, but yes, we are going to start the locking of the course. Those who have purchased the course, they are only going to see the classes. Okay. Yes, Arun Kumar, if you got the answer for that question, that's very good. So don't make such mistake in the GATE exam. Okay. If you have done any mistake, don't make such mistake in the exams. In this question, it is given that a manometer is used to measure the pressure in a tank. The fluid used has a specific gravity of 0.86 and the manometer column height is 50 centimeter. So the manometer is having the column height of 50 centimeter up to this height. Okay. As shown in the figure, if the local atmospheric pressure is 100 kilopascal, calculate the absolute pressure within the tank. You have to take the density of the water as 1000 kg per meter cube. It is again a very easy question. Just solve the question and tell me the answer quickly. Very good. Yes. Interested how to buy. Ben, if you are interested and if you have to buy the course of Vision 2021, the link for the course, the links are given in the description of this video. In the description of this video, you can find the link for Vision 2021 course. So if you go into the link of this course, you can find the link for, if you go in the description, you will find the link for Vision 2021 course. Okay. It is a very easy question. I should not take much time. The answer will be 104.21. You have to find the absolute pressure. Okay. Local pressure is given to you. That is 100 kilopascal. This is given here for this point. Okay. So the total pressure will be equal to, the total pressure, absolute pressure will be equal to local pressure plus gauge pressure. The local atmospheric pressure is 100 kilopascal plus gauge pressure. What is the gauge pressure? What is the gauge pressure? Gauge pressure has to be kept in kilopascal. So that is given in 0.860. That is given to you, specific gravity is 0.86. So for this height is given to you 50 centimeter. Difference in the two heights. So that what will be the gauge pressure? Gauge pressure up to this height will be equal to rho into g into h. So what will be the value of rho? It is 860. That is 860 into 9.81 into height. This is 50 centimeter. That will be 0.5. Okay. So you just have to add it here and you will get the answer. What is the answer you are getting for this? Yes. What is the answer that you will be getting for this question? I have to check one thing. You can also check here. Yes. So one thing I have to tell you all, this is a very, very important thing that I have to tell here. It is very important. This gauge pressure is in Pascal. This is in Pascal. Okay. But this pressure is given in kilopascal. Okay. So if we have to find this, if you are putting this value, you have to divide it by 1000. You have to divide by 1000. That is density into this acceleration to gravity into height divided by 1000. Then only you will get this pressure in kilopascal. Okay. So you have to find this value 100 kilopascal plus that will be 860 into 9.81 into 0.5 divided by 1000. Then you will get this value in kilopascal and you can add it. So after converting this in kilopascal and adding it, you will get the answer as 104.21. Okay. So whenever you find this pressure in rho gh, you get the answer in you will get the answer in pascal. And if you have to convert into kilopascal, you have to divide by 1000. Okay. Next question. I think this is the last question for this class. I have taken one more question, but that question will be from homework. So this is the last question that I am taking for this class. Yes, please solve this question. So in this question, they have given PB minus PA is 97 kilopascal. That is PB minus PA is 97 kilopascal. You have to find this height. This height you don't know. You don't know this height. This is given to 35. This is given to 18. You don't know the value of this height. Okay. Okay, this part is getting, this part is having Marian red oil, which is having specific gravity of 0.827. This part is having water. This is having water up to this height. This is height H. Okay. This is 18 centimeter height, which is having a specific gravity of 0.827. This is having mercury. This is completely having mercury. Okay. So read the question carefully and solve the question and tell me the answer. Mechanical design hub, I am seeing your comments. What is your question, mechanical design hub? Can I again see your question? Mechanical design hub, your question was manometer is a device which is used for measuring the velocity at a point in the fluid, pressure at a point, discharge, or none of the above. Well, manometer, mechanical design hub, if that is your name, it is always used to find the pressure. Sorry. It is always used to find the pressure at a point in the fluid. Okay, it is used to find the pressure at a point or difference of the pressure between two points. So that is a function of a manometer. Yes, have we solved the question? This question, the difference in the pressure is given to you, but this height is not given to you. This is a very good question. Good question. Yes, please solve it and tell me the answer quickly. Yes, come on, guys, hurry up. So I will not be taking much time of yours. The answer for this question will be, the correct answer is 22.41, or that is, or 22.41 centimeter, 24.45 centimeter. How to solve this question? If you have to solve this question, I will be reading going from this point, that is PA minus up to this height. The height is H. That will be minus. This is given to you 97 kilopascal. If this is given to you 97 kilopascal, can we say that we can convert all the pressure into kilopascal, right? So that will be, that this is given to you water. This is water, which is 1000 into 9.81 into H divided by 1000, because we are converting this pressure into kilopascal, because PA minus PB is given to you kilopascal, right? So if you have to convert this pressure in kilopascal, you have to divide by 1000, right? So that all the units become same. Now after this height, the liquid is having a specific gravity of 0.827. That will be 827 into 9.81 into, the height is 18 centimeter, that is 0.18 meter, divided by 1000. From this height, we have to go downward direction. We have to go in the downward direction up to this point. Okay, so if we have to go in the downward direction, that will be plus. This total height is equal to what? 35 plus 18 plus H. That will be 35 plus 18 is equal to 53. So that will be 136.00 into 9.81 into H plus 0.53 divided by 1000 is equal to PB. Okay, so you just have to take this PA that side, which is equal to PB minus PB, and you will get the value of H. H after solving this will be equal to 22.41 centimeter, approximately that will come out to be 22.45 centimeter. Okay. Tulsiram is having this query. Tulsiram, hello, what is the validity of the payment? Tulsiram, if you have any query regarding the payment of the course or any other query, you can contact our customer care number of GradeUp, that is 965005-2904. That is the number, 965005-2904. Okay, or help, you can mail on help@gradeup.co. Okay. So after solving this complete equation, PB minus P, you have to take this PA that side. You will get PB minus PA, which is 97 kilopascal. After solving it, you will get H as 22.41 or 0.2245 meter. That is correct. Either you will get this as 0.2241 meter, which is equal to 22.41 centimeter. Okay. The last question I am giving you for homework. You can read the question. You can take the snapshot of this question, and you can. The answer for this question you have to give in the comment box. Okay, in the comment box of this video, those who are in the app also, you can answer this question in the comment box. This is a homework question. It is a homework question. Okay, you can give the answer for this question in the comment box of the YouTube channel. Okay, so those who are in the YouTube and those who are not in the YouTube, those who are in the app, you can answer this question in the comment box. Okay, I will see the response and I will be asking the solution tomorrow in the tomorrow session. Okay, so this is a complete question. You can see this is PA given here. This is the point. This is A. This is having pressure of PA. This is B. Okay, and you have to find in this question the difference in the pressure A and B. Okay, so you can read the question. This is 80 mm, this is 200 mm, this is 100 mm, this is water, this is air, and this is oil. Okay, so you can take the snapshot of this and please give the answer in the comment box and I will be telling you who has given the right answer tomorrow. Okay, have you taken the snapshot? Yes, tell me. Okay, Rajdeep Singh or Raj Singh, you will definitely get all my guidance and all our expert faculty guidance. Okay, so my classes will start from 3rd of March. Please attend the classes regularly, okay, and seriously also. Whatever content we are providing in the classes, just follow it. And don't forget to solve the question given in the quiz after the session. And it's all simple, you just have to attend the classes regularly, those who have purchased the course. Solve the quiz after the class, go through the notes, that's it. Okay, that is the best you should do. And if you need any other suggestion from me or guidance from me, I'm always available to you. Okay, I hope you have taken the snapshot. You can mail me the answer. You can give the answer in the comment box. I will see the answer and I will tell you who has given the right answer for this question tomorrow. Okay, so Ronald Joshi has given the answer, plus Ronald Joshi, I'm not sure whether your answer is correct or not, because I'm not going to reveal it now. Okay, so please solve the question and tell me the answer tomorrow. Okay, that is a homework question. So that is all in this session, and before we end the session, this is very important information about Vision 2021 course. GradeUp has launched this course called Vision 2021. In this course, we are going to cover all the detailed syllabus of GATE and ESE 2021. So both GATE and ESE exam 2020 have been conducted, and those who want to have a full-fledged preparation for GATE and ESE 2021, you can join our this Vision 2021 course. In this course, we are going to cover the complete syllabus of GATE and ESE, technical and non-tech. Okay, we'll guide you for with the help of our lectures and with the help of our quizzes. So in this Vision 2021 course, you will get the complete syllabus of GATE and ESE for prelims and as well as mains. Okay, That will be covered in 550 plus hours of the live classes. Along with that, we'll get 150 plus hours of the live classes for ESC Prelims Paper 1. You will get 700 daily quizzes and conventional assignment for practice. And along with that, you will get subject test, full length mock test also, okay? All the classes for this Vision 2021 course will be in the evening. That is a very, very important feature of our course, that the classes will be in the evening, okay? So those who want to purchase the course, you can follow the link in the description of this video. In the description of this video, you can follow the link and you can directly go on to purchase this course. Now, this is very, very important. Those who are having, those who have qualified the GATE exam in 17, 18, 19, and those who have probable chance that they are going to qualify the GATE exam in 2020 also, you can purchase, you can get 50% off or 50% discount on the MRP of our Vision 2021 course, okay? This 50% discount is also for those students who have done their graduation from IIT, NIT or government colleges, okay? And if you have qualified the ESC Prelims paper, then also you will get this discount of 50%. If you have any query for this course, you can just contact our customer care of GradeUp. The number, the contact number is 965-00-52904. Please contact on this number if you have any query regarding the course or the discount, okay? Or you can also mail us on help@gradeup.co or anand.pandey@gradeup.co. They will definitely reply to your query, okay? So that is all. I hope it is clear to you all. Arun Kumar, next topic tomorrow on fluid mechanics in the startup ME is fluid kinematics. Fluid kinematics is also a very important topic. So let's meet tomorrow at 9 p.m. and let's explore the concept of fluid kinematics. Okay. Is this discount based on the BTEC or CGPA? Vishal Kumar, this discount is only based on if you have done your graduation or if you are if you are doing your graduation or your BTEC from IIT, NIT or any government college, irrespective of your CGPA, you will get the discount, okay? Now, this is a very important thing that you have to, you can see here. You can be a part of GradeUp Brigade for GATE 2020 CS Analysis. GATE 2020 CS Analysis will be on 8th of February, because GATE CS paper is on 8th of Feb. This is for those students who are from computer science branch. I know that you are from a mechanical branch. So if anyone is from the computer science branch, for the analysis of computer science paper on 8th of February, you can share the question and earn rewards. You just have to share the question on 85959 29130. This is a contact number for sharing the question for computer science paper of GATE 2020 on 8th of Feb. Okay, so if you share the question on this number, you will definitely get some rewards. It is only for computer science students, okay? It is a something which is very, very important, and it is not for mechanical guys. It is only for computer science, okay? So that is all in this session. I hope you all have understood this session. And that is all in this session. I hope I have tried to give you a basic clarity of manometry. We have solved few questions also from manometers. And so that is all in this session. Please solve the question of the homework. Ramya, Mohammed Toshif, and Ronald Joshi also have given the answer for that question. I'm not sure whether your answer is correct or not. That I'm going to reveal tomorrow. Okay. So see you tomorrow at 9 p.m. Also, you can give the answer to the homework question in the comment box. I will definitely see the comment box for that question. Okay. Biswajit Sarkar, you are asking for the discount, but regarding to what? You will get the discount if you have qualified the GATE exam in 17, 18, 19, and 20 GATE exam, or if you are pursuing your BTEC from IIT and IT. Or any government college, or if you have qualified the ESC prelims exam, then you will definitely get 50% discount. Okay. So that is all in this session. I hope I have tried to make clear the concept of manometry. I will see you tomorrow with another session on fluid kinematics in the Startup ME course. Okay, so see you tomorrow. Till then, prep smart, score better, go grade up.